We all know those baby animals are so cute they make us squeal and babble when we see them. But what exactly makes an animal adorable? Well, it might be the fact that they are usually perfectly round and extra fluffy, and humans associate these traits with the animals being friendly and harmless. First things first, today we are going to see some cute and charming animals. Giant panda. When giant pandas are born, the cubs are pink, blind, and hairless. They're also 1/900th the size of their mothers. Considering that adult female pandas can weigh over 200 pounds, the baby bears are puny. Marsupials, such as kangaroos, are the only other mammals that exhibit such a large difference in size between newborns and mothers. The reason for the cubs' diminutive bodies pertains to the species' bamboo diet. Given that bamboo contains very little nutritional value, grown pandas must eat up to 80 pounds of the plant each day, so their nutritional needs are met. It is easier for the animal to convert bamboo into milk than to animal tissue. See turtles. Watching a baby turtle, known as a hatchling, struggle out of the nest and make its way to the water is an emotional experience. Everything from footprints to driftwood and crabs are obstacles, though this gauntlet is important for its survival. Birds, raccoons, and fish are just a few of the predators these vulnerable creatures face. Some experts say only 1 out of 1,000 will survive to adulthood under natural conditions. After an adult female sea turtle nests, she returns to the sea, leaving her nest and the eggs within it to develop on their own. The amount of time the egg takes to hatch varies among the different species and is influenced by environmental conditions such as the temperature of the sand. The hatchlings do not have sex chromosomes, so their gender is determined by the temperature within the nest. Giraffes. They are the tallest land animal in the world. With a world population that is under 100,000, many conservationists say they are endangered. Giraffes are mammals and are naturally found in Africa. Giraffe babies or calves are some of the biggest newborns on record. Mama giraffes give birth to live babies after 14 months of gestation. When a baby giraffe is born, it drops up to 6 feet to the ground and lands on its head. The fall does not hurt the baby giraffe at all, but makes it take a deep first breath. After an hour or so, the baby can walk on her own. When baby giraffes are born, they have an average height of 6 feet and can weigh anywhere from 100 to 150 pounds. Baby giraffes are considered fully mature, or adults, around the time they turn 4 years old. Male giraffes will grow up to 18 feet tall and can weigh up to 3,000 pounds, and female giraffes can be up to 14 feet tall and weigh 1,500 pounds when fully grown. Baby giraffes will gain most of that height and weight in the first 3 years of life. Koala. When early European settlers first encountered koalas in Australia, they thought the tree-climbing animals were bears or monkeys. Even today, people still incorrectly refer to koalas as koala bears. But koalas are actually marsupials, closer related to wombats and kangaroos. A koala's pregnancy lasts 35 days. When the joey is born, it is only 2 centimeters, less than an inch, long. It is hairless, blind, and has undeveloped ears. But the newborn does have very strong forelimbs and an instinct to climb from the birth canal into the mother's pouch. There the baby finds a nipple, which swells in its mouth, keeping the joey in place. After the joey spends 6 months in the pouch developing, the mother koala will produce a special substance called pap. In order for the joey to start eating leaves, it will need the bacteria in its intestines. So the joey feeds on pap in addition to milk for several weeks before leaving the pouch. A joey will stay with its mother for 6 more months after first venturing out of the pouch. In this time, the joey learns how to grasp leaves with its hands and returns to the pouch to hide or sleep. When the joey becomes too large, it may ride on its mother's back or abdomen. At 1 year of age, the joey can live on its own. Seahorse. Seahorses prefer to swim in pairs with their tails linked together. They swim upright and avoid predators by mimicking the color of underwater plants. Seahorses have no teeth and no stomach. Food passes through their digestive systems so quickly, they must eat almost constantly to stay alive. They can consume 3,000 or more brine shrimp per day. Rarer still, they are among the only animal species on Earth in which the male bears the unborn young. Male pregnancy frees to female to make more eggs straight away and so reproduce quicker. When mating, the female seahorse releases up to 50 eggs into a pouch on the male's abdomen. The male seahorse carries the eggs in his pouch until they hatch, then releases fully formed, miniature seahorses into the water. As little as 5, or as many as 1,500 young can be born. The baby seahorses are then on their own. They have to deal with predators, ocean currents, etc. No wonder that less than half of them survive until adulthood. So I hope you guys enjoyed this short video. If you did, make sure to leave a like, comment, and also subscribe to the channel. Until next time.